Yes, I do remember my password. I just don't remember to give myself as much love as I give others, and that fucks up my mental health, and that's why I don't post on YouTube enough. But that doesn't mean I forgot my password. I do remember my password. Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're gonna go get a piercing, and you're coming along with me. So I just really hope that the next 10, 15-ish minutes would make you happy, would be slightly different than the kind of day you had. Let me know the kind of day you had. Really want to talk to you guys in the comments, because I feel like our interaction has gone down a little bit, because obviously my dumbass does not post enough anymore. Today I'm gonna go get a helix piercing. I already had one over here. I did in fact vlog it a couple of years ago, but at the start of the pandemic, my dumbass thought it would be a great idea to take it out, and I did, and it just got closed. So I just want to go and get that done. I have a very strong feeling I will slip up and get a couple of extra piercings also. We'll find out. I'm brushing my hair. It's like 6:30 right now. I took a real quick shower because I had oil in my hair, and I'm gonna go get my piercing because I need something to feel alive. So let's go. I am in the cab now. I'm on my way to GKM block, and there's one piece of advice I have for you. If you're going for a piercing or a tattoo, just make sure you've eaten something, so that when you're going through the process, because you know people are already very, not really I would say scared, but like on edge moments before they're getting a tattoo or moments before they're getting a piercing, and there's obviously some pain. Like no matter what your pain tolerance level is like, you are gonna feel some amount of pain. So in order to like make sure you don't faint, or like, you know, your BP doesn't go down and stuff like that, just make sure you have a nice meal. If you haven't had a meal, or if there's no like food place around the parlor where you're getting tattooed or getting pierced, like just buy a fruit juice, because you know that is overloaded with sugar, and that should give you some amount of energy that is very, very required before you get a tattoo or a piercing. I just got off at GKM block, and I just found out that I forgot to get a scrunchie, which is very important to tie your hair when you're getting like all of these ear piercings, because if your hair gets tangled in their piercing, it's like another level of pain. So I'm just gonna go find a scrunchie from one of these, you know, street shops, and then we're gonna go to that end of the road and get pierced. Rubber band has been secured. I was very tempted to get a scrunchie, but here is scrunchie 50 rupees ka bech raha hai, and Green Park mein a scrunchie, I'm getting stares. Cute. Anyway, I've decided that I'm not gonna get like weirded out today, because that always happens when I'm trying to vlog, and then like I have to dump the vlog because I feel like it's shit. But not today. I'm on another level of confidence today. But yeah, going back to the story, I was very tempted to get a scrunchie, but then I didn't. Apple. Should I waste my money? No. Anyway, scrunchie, bro. Let's get back to the story. I was very tempted to get the scrunchie, but I did not, because Green Park mein 20 rupees ka milta hai. So I'm not gonna waste 30 bucks like that, right? Anywho, Malhotra Jewelers at GKM Block. This is where we are gonna go. It's a pull door. Anyway, I did actually come here for a piercing back when I was in college. So it'll be fun to see if they remember me, which they won't, because I'm like nobody. But we'll see. I really like this. This is size 8. And this is size 10. Slightly bigger, but I don't think it'll be that big. Achha dikhega. And right now I'm gonna see some rings and then figure out which two I want over here. Oh, achha, ring aise normal silver type. Ye ball samne ki taraf rahega ya peeche?
Aapki marzi hai, marzi aage kari peeche kari.
अच्छा, हीलिंग में कौन सा बेटर रहता है, रिंग या स्टड?
स्टड बढ़िया रहता है,
स्टड जल्दी हील होता है. ठीक है, तो फिर मैं दो स्टड्स ही करा लूंगी. हेयर हैज बीन टाइड सो दैट इट डजंट मेस विद माय पियर्सिंग, एंड जस्ट मोमेंट्स अवे फ्रॉम गेटिंग इट डन. काइंड ऑफ नॉट रियली स्कैर्ड, बिकॉज़ आई हैव गॉटन मल्टीपल टैटूज एंड पियर्सिंग सिंस देन, लाइक सिंस आई लास्ट गॉट दिस वन डन बैक इन कॉलेज. बट स्टिल, आई मीन, एज आई टोल्ड यू गाइस इन द कैब, इट इज प्रीटी स्कैरी एंड डज पुट यू ऑन द एज. बट ही इज रेडी, ही इज सैनिटाइजिंग हिज hands, and I'm fully prepared to pass out, actually, like faint, but I've eaten well this time, so I should not faint.
So here it is. That's it.
Okay, done.
And just a few seconds of coiling process.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. This one was quite painless actually, so that's great. नीचे वाले में थोड़ा शायद दर्द हो सकता है, but it's okay. It's okay. Also shout out to भैया जिन्होंने कैमरा पकड़ा है. Thank you so much भैया. आपका नाम क्या है?
सुन.
Thank you सुनो भैया. Okay. दूसरा वाला अभी इधर ही कर रहे हैं पहले. Okay. धीरे धीरे.
It's okay man.
अयो.
That's. Diminishing होगा, like I hope it was not as horrible as you were expecting.
No, it wasn't. I don't know why I remember my original one being so painful.
Done.
बहुत tight तो नहीं है ना दोनों?
नहीं ma'am, दोनों की coiling मैंने use की है.
Okay, this is what it looks like. If you can see, both are done. I'm sure it looks wonderful. Now the other ear.
That's
right.
ठीक है ना? क्या खराब है तो सही है? हाँ, सही है। बीटा टीन की एक लिक्विड की शीशी ले लीजिएगा, not a tube, liquid. So या तो ईयरबड या टेक अ कॉटन डिप करके अगेन सॉफ्ट रबिंग फ्रंट एंड बैक, so that like whole absorbs that liquid inside और वो जल्दी हील अप हो जाए.
Okay.
For a 1 week.
Okay.
And number 3, make sure it shouldn't get pulled all of sudden. साबुन से फेस वाइप करें, मास्क पहने. Nowadays अभी तो मास्क भी एड ऑन हो गया, सो मास्क पहने, क्लोथ चेंज करें, कॉम करें हेयर्स में, सो मेक श्योर इसकी बैक को कंघी में ना लगे.
ओके. एंड कभी कभी जो क्रस्ट अक्यूमुलेट हो जाता है ना, वो उसको निकालना चाहिए या वही वाइप करते टाइम जितना हटेगा हटेगा? क्योंकि कई लोग वो जो अक्यूमुलेट होता है उसको ऐसे ऐसे करके निकालते हैं, नहीं करना चाहिए.
कॉटन से ही रबिंग करके.
ओके, व्हाइल पुटिंग बेटाडाइन एंड ऑयल. ओके, सो दैट्स योर आफ्टर केयर फॉर अ पियर्सिंग. थैंक यू सो मच सोनू भैया. थैंक यू. आई विल जस्ट पे एंड वी विल मेक अ मूव फॉर होम.
चलो जी.
थैंक यू सो मच.
सच अ लॉन्ग टाइम.
आफ्टर 4 इयर्स.
आफ्टर यस, ऑलमोस्ट 4 इयर्स एंड वी वुड लव यू टू कम अगेन.
फॉर श्योर.
आई एम गोना सी यू आफ्टर अ कपल ऑफ वीक्स जस्ट टू हैव अ नॉर्मल लुक. की होल लाइक इफ अगर होल फॉर्मड हो गया होगा, वी विल गो फॉर अ चेंज.
कूल. थैंक यू सो मच. सो गाइस, आई जस्ट गॉट आउट. आई एम so happy with my piercings. This looks so cute. I love it. I'm outside. I'm just gonna take a quick round of GKM block because I've been wanting to come here काफी time से. Okay brother. जब मैं college में थी ना, this was the market that we used to come to all the time. Like all my groups, all my friends. I कहाँ चल रहे हैं? GKM block चलते हैं, because this is the closest from my college. But obviously I haven't been here in a long, long time, and there are really nice outlets here. There's Global Desi and Cafe Coffee Day, and also there's Body Shop. I've been in love with their products throughout the pandemic. So I think I'm just gonna go in, take a look, and then head home. It's only 8-ish right now, so we have a lot of time. Also, why am I so dark? Why am I dark? What is happening? Okay, we're back. I am at Body Shop and I just tried this lipstick. This is the tester I tried. I think I'm gonna get it. Not really able to. What's the shade called? I'll just get one of these. Oh, there's no name to this. Just numbers. Okay, cool. Shrishma likes one of these perfumes. I think it's this one. No, not this one. It's some other musk one. I actually called Trisha and asked her if she needs something from here, but she's not responding. So Trisha Modi, that's what you get for not responding to me. You won't get your perfume. I'll only get my lipstick. And yeah, just gonna get this build real quick and leave for home because I'm running late now. I feel like I'm the queen of bad lighting on YouTube now. But it's okay, you know, it's fine. This is my comfort space. I'm comfortable here. So this is how it's gonna be. Also, I am back home, if you couldn't tell. I absolutely love my piercings. I think they look really great. I just quickly wanted to talk to you guys about the aftercare. This is the slip. No, this is not. This is my bank account statement. This is the aftercare slip that they gave me. Feel free to pause the video and check it out. And that being said, I just quickly wanted to have a word with you guys regarding aftercare in itself. So I get a ton of DMs and comments on YouTube asking me about aftercare for a tattoo or a piercing, because back when I was in college, I was a tattoo and piercing enthusiast, and I made a couple of videos on it which somehow blew up on my channel, and I think that's why a lot of people have viewed it and they feel like they should DM me to ask about aftercare. But I'm gonna be really honest with you guys, there's no person who's better to ask for this aftercare questions and queries and everything that you guys reach out to me for than the person who's actually doing your piercing, because these people are experts, okay? Like, you should always go with an expert's opinion when it comes to tattoos and piercings and things of that sort. In comparison to a 23-year-old stranger on the internet, I mean, I will like help you out if you're like in an emergency situation or something, or like you have some general queries or doubts. But if you just DM me frantically, hey, I got tattooed from like this sadak side wala shop and now it's like bleeding and infected, what do I do? I literally won't know it. So just like, don't get tattooed from a sadak side shop, one. And two, like, just ask the person who's doing it to you and for you as to what the appropriate aftercare is. I also get asked this other question very often: dard hua kya? Obviously it hurts. It's not a tap on your shoulder, it is a piercing that goes through your skin, through your not muscle, but yeah, like skin. And of course it does hurt, but then again, pain tolerance completely different for someone. So this piercing when I was younger did not hurt at all, because this is like a loosey-goosey area with no like bone or like cartilage and stuff. This, the first time I got my helix piercing back in college, I passed out for 20 minutes. Today when I got that one done again, it didn't hurt. The one under it that I got done, again, didn't hurt a lot. It did feel a little pricky, but yeah, nowhere near the same amount of pain that I had back in college. So yeah, pain tolerance again is different. It will hurt you, but I really can't say how much. And I just quickly wanted to touch base with you guys on something that happened to me last week. So basically at the end of my last vlog, I was contemplating quitting YouTube and never posting ever again on this platform. And then last weekend I actually met a couple of friends, and I was just, you know, on the side talking to one of those friends whose opinion I really, really value. And they actually gave me a very, very nice thought. Like, they just put this really nice thought in my mind, which was like, don't tie your self-worth or like your self-image or like, you know, your self-esteem to a certain task or to a certain role in your life. You know, like an example of that would be my work life, like my official office work life. Like, while performance at work should really be a priority for me and I should strive to do my best and contribute in the best possible way and just, you know, yield the best outcome for my company and the people I'm working for, one bad day at work should not make me feel like I'm a loser and I'm a waste of space and I should just die and, like, you know, extremely negative emotions. Like, one bad day at work should not mean like my self-image and my self-worth is nothing. Some days when I would not be able to create good content on YouTube and like I would see the footage that I filmed and I hate it and I delete it, I would just feel like a loser. I'd feel like, oh my god, what am I doing? I'm so privileged and yet I'm like wasting all of it. I don't deserve to live, and all of those extreme thoughts. But then after the talk with her, I just realized, like, no, I got great marks, I graduated from a great college, I have a job, I do my job very well, I try to be helpful to others, I try to be nice to others, and there's so much more to me than just YouTube. That being said, YouTube, not like it's not important to me, but one bad day at YouTube should not mean like I suck, because I don't. So, secret message of this whole story was this, that just in case you're beating yourself up about something today, maybe a task that you want to do which you're just not able to achieve or like tick off your list today, don't beat yourself up about it today. Because your self-worth is so much more than that, because you are doing so much more than that. So give yourself credit for the other things you're doing, because, you know, when you're looking through the magnifying glass of that one task which you're not able to do, it may look like, oh my god, you're worthless, but you're not. That's the point. Tomorrow is a work day. I might vlog tomorrow. we'll see. That being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this short, nice, crisp vlog. I'll see you guys soon.
East and the west, I'm racking up on my breath, power on me, I'm feeling just like a Tesla. Too much tree, the smoke is making my chest hurt. Girl on me, I'm thinking I should arrest her.